Hello team, this side Karthik. Welcome to my channel Tech Solution. Today in this video session we will discuss about VI editor called Visual Editor file, okay, which is the most important things from Linux. And inside that there have n number of options, so we should have those options because when it's required and what kind of things is required, we have to remember these options. According to that, we need to go ahead to edit that file. This is nothing else. They have, you know, some kind of files as I mentioned earlier. This is a part of file type called Visual Editor, called VI you can say. By that we can create the file which can support much more data compared to cat file. Okay, when we are creating a file by cat, we are not getting that that many options, whatever options is available in the VI editor. But and that is a one demerit. And second demerit is when are going to edit something in a particular file, that file should create by VI editor. So for that we can enter by VI and we can edit whatever we want inside that. Getting me? So what we cannot do in the directly in cat files. Okay, well, so let me create a file and let me enter inside that as well, do something as per the VI editor options, right? So let me check which file is suitable for us. This is a file, right? So this is a file. Which file? There have n number of files. Okay, I'm not creating a file because if we'll create a file, in that file only I need to we need to type data and all those things. But if still you want to create a file, you can create by VI. Suppose I want to create a file called VI1. Okay, called VI1. So this is the file. If you want to type, if you want to write some data here, how you will type? You just need to come like this way and just hit escape key, then hit I key from keyboard. Then if you here you want to type, you can type according to whatever data you want to put, right? Suppose I want to write some data here about myself. Okay, so what I will type? Hi, beside Karthik, or I can type here my good name is Karthik Chandra Sahu. Okay, I belongs to, or I can type in the, I'll create new line so for that it will be good. I belongs to Orissa. I am a BTech guy or BTech degree guy, or let me mention BTech guy. I do have, or I am bearing 4.1 years of experience. I worked two more organization. My first company was Dell International. And second one is IBM Global, where I am right now working and about my hobby. I love to play cricket and about my family. There are 4 members. My father is a farmer. My mother is a homemaker. And my brother is a mechanical engineer. And moreover, about my day-to-day activities, is I used to handle LVM, SVM, VXVM, ZFS, Jones, patch activity, patch administration, co-meeting with vendor for any hardware replacement. And I do have 2 ticketing tool, Hanson experience as well. I do work on change management. That's all about myself and my day-to-day activity. Thank you. This many data I have written in this particular file, right? I want to save it. How I'll save? Escape, Shift, Colon, W is nothing but write, Q is nothing but quit. W is nothing but write or save, Q is nothing but quit, and then hit exclamation mark, then hit enter key. Okay, so now my VI1 has been created successfully. If you want to check man page also, you can check about VI. You can check about VI. See, this is the man page about VI. N number of things would be available there. Okay, you can, if you want, you can read this file for your better understanding. When require what? -q error file, -t tag. N number of files would be, n number of option would be available. Some of the option is required, some of the option is frequently not required. Okay, many things would be there. If you read it, you will understand properly. Many things, n number of things would be there. Okay, so let me come out. So like that I created a file, right? Then I saved that. Now let me come to CD. Suppose I want to enter in a file. How I will enter? As I shown you, this is the way, escape and insert mode, right? So, and if you want, you can save that by executing WQ exclamatory mark, right? Suppose let me again open that file vi. This is the file, right? So I want to quit that file. I want to quit that file without saving. So suppose before that I want to let me come to end of the line. So how will come to end of the line? Escape shift g. This is the end line, okay? And I want to type something there, so escape I. Now it's insert mode. Now I type blah, blah blah something like that, okay? Now I don't want to save it. Suppose by mistake you return something in a particular file, or you edit something in a particular way with, by mistake, and you don't want to save it. What you need to do, you just need to hit escape key and shift colon. Here you need to come Q and exclamatory, or escape shift Q, Q and exclamatory. Come up. Now it's not saved. How you'll come to know whether it's saved or not? By executing vi, then vi. See, last line written something blah blah blah. It's not showing there because of I did not save it. Right? Now, if suppose my cursor is high, my cursor is on H, right? Suppose let me come here. Okay, my cursor is on Y. I want to add some text after Y. So how will add? By pressing escape and A. So here I want to type something. My good name, I written in good only. I want to type something. Okay, bat, something I written. Okay. If now I want to save it, just escape shift colon, then WQ. W is right, Q for quit exclamation. Now it's saved. I will come to know if it's saved or not by opening that. See. My bad, good name, something like that, blah blah blah. That is available, right? Now, my cursor is on H. Okay, I want to add some data is here. Where? Here. I mean, end of the line. So how I'll add? Now, what I need to do? I just need to press escape key from the keyboard, escape, then shift A. Now my cursor is on. Okay, here if I want, I can type something. My nickname is Kriti. Now it's written. If I want to save, then escape shift colon WQ exclamatory mark. Now it's saved. Whether it's saved or not, how I will come to know? You need to open that, or if you don't want to open, you can go through by cat vi1. It will show. If you don't want to open that file, or if you want to open that file, you need to enter that by vi1. Right, so I want to replace character. I want to replace character. How will replace one on character? How the key is escape R. See, first it was H. That H has been replaced now. Instead of H, it's showing R because of I space two time R. Right. So if I'll come here, escape. So let me go. My cursor is on H, right? I want to replace H. Escape R. Now it's replaced, right? Now I want to save it. So escape shift colon WQ exclamation. Now it's saved. How I will come to know whether that H has been removed or not? By entering VI1 or cat VI, you can come to know. See, instead of H, R is there because of that H has been replaced. Now, if you want to, instead of have something you want to write, you can write that. Now, I want to replace complete entire line. Okay, how you will replace? By escape shift R. Escape shift R. Now, see, that line has been replaced. If you want, you can replace now. If you want to delete, you can delete. You can delete. Okay. like this way. If you want, you need to go for the replace, and here whatever you want you can type. Suppose I want to remove everything. I want to write here my nickname. My nickname is Kritik. Now I want to save. Escape shift colon WQ extracted. Now it has been saved. I will come to whether it's saved or not. See, instead of my good name something blah blah blah, it's saying my nickname is Kritik. So let me enter one second in that. VI. Okay. So suppose see my first line is my nickname is Kriti and my second line is I belongs to Orissa, right? So what I just need to do in between my nickname and I belongs to Orissa, I want to create one more line. How you will create? By escape and O. Now see, one more line has been created. If you here you want to type something like, you can type my good name is Kartik. I want to save. You can say escape WQ exclamated. Now it's saved. I will come to know whether it's saved or not. VI1. See, it's saved. Now you want to enter in VI1. Just enter inside the VI1. Right? So this is the, you know, how you can create a line in between two lines. Okay. So I want to add a line. So above of a line. Suppose here I am right now, right? My above line is this one. My first company was Dell International and my second company is IBM, where I'm working right now, right? So I want to add one line after and. It means and my, in between one line I want to add. But if I'll go to my, then I can use escape O, it will create one more line here, right? But I don't want to do that. I want to create one more line above my line. Suppose I am on A. I want to create one more line above on this line. So how I will create? By shift O. Escape, shift O. See, one line has been created. Suppose I don't want to do that. I want to create one line after my nickname. So how I will create? Escape, shift O. See, my first line has been created there. Right? So now I want to save it. Escape, shift colon, WQ exclamation. Now it has been saved. I will come to know by VI. See, my first line has been created, and this is also a simple line I created. I did not type any data. That is also saved, right? Now, I want to change some word. I want to change some word. So, escape, C, W. I want to change word. Okay, my second one. Here my second one I earlier it was my. Suppose I will type something. Mine, instead of mine I will type mine. And if you want to save, escape W, shift colon WQ exclamation. Now you want to enter in that. See, instead of mine now it's mine, right? So if you want to replace a, if you want to change a word also, you can change like this way, escape CW. Escape DW also one more option would be there. So if you want to delete the word, you can delete. Suppose this mine, I want to delete it. What I'll do? Escape DW. See, mine has been deleted now. Right? So, and now, suppose, you know, I want to delete a particular one on character. So what I'll do? Escape. X, escape, X, 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 X. See, it has been deleted. If you want to delete one character, okay. If you want to delete completely line, what you need to do? Escape, DD. Two times you need to press DD. Then only it will delete. Okay. And if you want to delete number of line, if you want to delete number of line, you can delete by executing escape and that how many line you want to delete, and then DD, it will delete. Suppose I want to delete last two line. Okay, so what I'll do? Escape 2 DD. See, last two line has been deleted, right? Now whatever thing has been deleted, I want to make it undo. What I'll do? Escape U. See, it's coming, right? This is called undo. Okay, suppose you want to copy some line. I want to copy from here. Okay, from here to this three line I want to copy. So what I'll do, escape, escape. Suppose you want to copy only one line, escape yy, and I want to paste completely bottom of the file. So how will come bottom of the file? Escape shift g, then escape o, escape I, escape p. See this which I copied the first line, that is pasted here. Okay, now if you want to change this, you can change it. Like if you want to, so for paste is escape p. Suppose you want to paste here, suppose let me copy one more line. Okay, suppose I want to copy this line, so escape yy. Okay, and I want to paste above this line. I want to paste above this line. So what I need to do, escape shift p. See, it is storing above that line. It means one more line will get above that line where will be your cursor, and there it will save this line which line you copy, right? Suppose now I want to copy this three line, first line, second line, third line. How I'll copy? Escape 3yy. Now three line has been copied. Suppose I want to paste here. Suppose I want to paste here this three line. What I'll do? Escape p. See, this three line has been copied here and pasted, right? So now suppose I want to do redo. I want to do redo. Undo, redo, you know that. So what I saw first, the undo. Suppose I want to make it redo. So how I will do? By escape, then control shift R. Already newest changes. Okay. So redo already been done. If you want to undo, you can undo. Escape U. So now it's undo. Okay. It was redo only. Now escape, control shift R. Now it's redo. Getting now. Suppose I am here. Suppose I am here. Take an example. You are here. Completely, extremely end of the line. Extremely end of the line. You want to come home of the line. So what how you will come to home of the line? How you will come? By escape GG. By escape GG. It is going to first line first. Right? Suppose you want to move the cursor by word, what you'll do? Escape B. Let me come here. Escape B. It will move word by word from the end to till first. Okay. See, it's moving from word by word. Okay. If you want to move forward by, so what you need to do? Escape W. So it will go till forward. Towards end. Getting? Suppose you want to see how many lines are there. You here too many line, here only very few number of line. If you want, you can count it. Okay, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Something like that. Okay, but still you want to make line numbers. I will make escape shift colon. You need to type here set nu. Hit enter. What it will do? It will give line numbers. Okay, so there have suppose like almost around 500 lines. Okay, but you don't want to waste your time, right? So there will be something like, you know, logically how you will come to know how many lines would be there. So if we'll execute set nu, we can come to know how many lines are there. Okay, suppose here it's few lines. Okay, so it will be not a big challenge for you. Let me come out and show you in the different file. One file would be there called vi var log messages, var log messages. Let me enter. There are n number of files, right? So here I want to set the line number. See, now line number has been set. Line number has been set till my end. Okay, so no need to count it. There are n number of lines. Getting me? So this is what the way you can set the line number. Now if you want to remove the line number, how will you remove? By executing escape shift colon. Here you need to type set none. It will remove the line number. Getting me? Now come to our own file vi, which file we have been created, vi1. Here suppose you want to move your cursor to a particular line. So let me first set the line number. Now line has been created, right? I want to move 10 number of line. I want to move, my cursor is first only, right? My cursor is here. I want to move here directly. So how I'll move? By escape shift colon. Shift colon, line number is 10. See, my cursor is on 10. Right? Suppose I want to move to a particular word. So, what I'll do? Escape, shift colon, slash. Suppose I want to move about word. About. I want to move my cursor where abouts would be available. See, this line about is there, this line about is there, other lines about are not there, so it will go simply. Okay, now shift colon 1 comma dollar s. I want to detail about. So what I'll do, whatever about are there, it will remove all the about, and instead of about it will type detail. So let's go ahead and do that. It's not right. Somewhere I did some mistake, so that is not happening. So sorry, old one. Here I need to give about. Here I need to give new one. Yes. See, instead of about, it is written details, digital details. So all the about has been removed, right? So if you want to remove a word by this way, you can remove it. Okay. So this is all about VI editor file, VI edition file. How to create a VI editor, and inside that how you guys need to manage it. Okay, thanks a lot to everyone, to basically for newcomers, for freshers who are following to me. I like to request please subscribe my channel, so for that I can bring new tech solutions in front of you by playing those videos day by day. You can upgrade yourself, and you guys will be eligible in near future for a better opportunity. Thanks a lot once again to everyone.